Prime Minister, Right Honourable Robina Nabanja, who says that 413,504 people have now received the 100,000 Uganda shillings COVID relief cash that government says is aimed at helping them overcome the obstacles and the hardships that have been conditioned by the lockdown and the COVID-19 pandemic. The Prime Minister's statement, however, did not go down well with members of Parliament, who said their constituents are suffering during this lockdown. Our reporter has the details.
Honourable members, Madam Speaker.
After several interruptions by members of Parliament, Prime Minister Robina Nabanja read her statement on government response towards the resurgence of COVID-19. She noted that by close of business yesterday, 413,504 vulnerable poor people had received their relief financial support, which indicates 82% progress, with 45.35 billion so far paid up. 87,503 beneficiaries have been bounced after their submissions were rejected in the verification process of telecom companies. Many had their telephone numbers registered in different names on top of other mismatching details.
The number of targeted beneficiaries, households, was 501,107 across the cities and municipalities. The total number of beneficiaries paid as at yesterday, 4 p.m., totals to 400,135 beneficiary records had been submitted to the bank and paid, which represents 82.5%. That totals to 41,350,400 Uganda shillings.
The Prime Minister also indicated that district local governments were allocated 150 million shillings, cities 150 million shillings, and municipalities 100 million shillings.
This exercise of providing relief support to our people has shown us that we need, one, to invest in collecting, analyzing, and documenting data about our citizens accurately. For example, in the process of verifying beneficiaries, we found that some of the people's telephone numbers were registered under different names from those on their national identity numbers. In other cases, beneficiaries submitted telephone numbers not registered on mobile money.
According to the Prime Minister, the government is now using missions abroad to search for available sources of vaccines after failing to purchase vaccines directly on the open market.
Direct purchase of vaccines through COVAX facility. Direct purchase of vaccines through African Union. Direct purchase of vaccines from the open market. Various vaccines have been listed for use in Uganda, including AstraZeneca, Covishield, Pfizer, Johnson & Johnson, Moderna, Sinopharm, and Sinovac. In the content of the global scarcity of vaccines, government through our missions abroad is aggressively searching for the available source, and we will procure the vaccines that we can access. Many of you will recall that in the budget speech, Uganda shillings 560 billion was allocated to COVID-19 vaccinations.
However, in his response, the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, asked the government to move in with more solid interventions towards the welfare of Ugandans battling with the lockdown.
Right, Honourable Speaker, every citizen is feeling the wrath of having a government that makes incomprehensible planning and decisions that I'm going to highlight briefly. Let me comment on the overall government response. If I was a terrible human being, I would have called it government posturing. It is evident, right, Honourable Speaker, that government's response focuses on ad hoc interventions in health and social protection, neglecting dividends that would arise from a comprehensive review of undertakings in other sectors such as education, infrastructure.
Honorable Speaker, the welfare of teachers is priority because it has a multiplier effect on retention and the quality of education in schools.
Right, Honorable Speaker, allow my office put it to your attention that as of now, there is no exit strategy that is visible to us and even the public for this particular lockdown of the 42 days. We seem to be in an indefinite lockdown.
Parliament expressed concern over the dragging approach of government in procurement of COVID-19 vaccines.
Prime Minister is being wishy-washy as far as vaccination is concerned. When you look at her plans, she says, yes, we shall get some vaccines from COVAX and so on. Can we get some specificities? Because, I mean, it's all over the world, you know, countries elsewhere are opening up because they have vaccinated majority of their population. And so it looks like vaccination is the panacea.
The lawmakers asked the government to tame security brutality in enforcement of lockdown restrictions and also provide special transport to medical workers. Story by Fred Kajubi.